In this video, I'm gonna show you how to create a 6 email drip sequence in one day. Let's get started. Here we are at my martial arts school, Ekata, and we're gonna help them to build a video email sequence. First thing that you're gonna wanna do is to figure out what your ideal client profile is. We're gonna create 6 videos that can fuel their YouTube channel, their social channels, to create an email drip sequence with, and to even use in a newsletter they can send via email and SMS. When you think about your ideal client profile, you wanna think about a couple of things. Number one, where in the world are they located? What is their age? What title do they hold? What are their key demographic and psychographics? And most importantly, what are the problems that they're suffering from? What are their pain points? If you don't understand those, you can't do this project.
Typically in their onboarding process, they explain a lot of different facets of the business. They talk about the products, the services that they offer. They talk about the overarching themes within their program, and they talk about what's expected so that people can see results.
Okay. This is really important to note. Every business has a different sales cycle. For some businesses, it takes a day to get a client. For others, it takes a week or a month. And even for others, it takes months or even sometimes years. So as you think about what your sales cycle is, try to figure out what your sequence is gonna focus on. A 7-day sequence is not for everyone. Sometimes you wanna create a 7-month sequence.
Since there's so many facets of this between mindfulness, exercise, martial arts, community building, to figure out a way to incorporate all of it, but to weave it together with a common thread. Most importantly, we need to make sure that it's not salesy, rather educational and something entertaining to watch.
When you figure out the length and the cadence of your emails, you can start to populate the content and make it really intentional, and ultimately you will achieve 2 goals. Number one is to increase your conversion rates, and number two is to decrease your sales cycle. Those are the most important metrics on this one. Let's keep going. So next, we're gonna focus on the message. The message is copywriting for the email messages and the scripts for the videos. We recommend a collaborative environment where you can start to write and then bounce ideas off your team. We use Google Docs. If you write the email copy and the video script at the same time, you avoid the risk of it being redundant. And I think what really glues all of these together is to have a motif, a theme. Is it comedic underlays? Is it something witty? Is it thought leadership? Is it statistics? Whatever that motif is, start to incorporate that into all of the work. Now let's get into project management. We use a tool called Asana, but there are so many out there. Get your script ready, get your email ready, and get your shot locations. And since this is focused on video, get your production ideas ready. Where you're shooting the video, who's gonna be in it, what is the background, and so on. So next is the shoot. Now you wanna get your camera ready. Your phone will work great. If you're at your home, if you're at your office, if you're outdoor, record your 6 videos. You can record them in the same place, or you can add variety and have them in different places. There's a couple of simple tools that you can use if you want to have a stable camera. You can use a selfie stick, you can use a tripod, you can even prop your phone on a couple of books. Now, one thing I might recommend is to make sure that your lighting and your microphone are good. Natural light sources from a window or from outdoors, or LED lights work great. With respect to your microphone, you wanna make sure that you don't have a lot of background noise, that you have a clear mic that's not too far away from your mouth. Once you've shot your videos, you can then take your videos to the writing stage. Great thing about this is you can view the video files that you shot and then write according to that. If you're gonna delegate this to someone on your team, send them a Google Drive or a Dropbox folder, or even use Dubb to share those videos. Once your copywriting is done and once the videos are ready to go, you wanna get to the organization stage. This means you wanna create your email drip sequence. You can create this in a lot of different platforms, but in this video, I'm going to show you how to use Dubb to do that. Here we are in the Dubb automation section. I'm going to show you an existing automated workflow, which is actually an email drip campaign. The first thing that you'll want to do is to make sure that you have a trigger step. The traditional step would be when a tag is added, but you'll notice that there's a number of options when a CTA is clicked, video watched, or even when a video page is viewed. In this case, this is going to be a tag-based trigger. So when this tag gets added to any contact, they will get added to this workflow. The build process is where it gets fun. In this campaign, what we've done is we've set up an internal notification so that we internally can receive a message when a lead is added to our system. After that step, there's a delay of 3 days. The reason why we have this delay is because this is an email nurture campaign. The goal of this campaign is to drip educational videos and emails to a prospect to help convert them in our sales funnel. The second step, of course, after the delay is to send an email campaign. In this case, we've selected drip email number 2, which is saved to the campaign section on the Dubb platform. After that, you can create a series of different types of steps, such as delays, more sending campaigns, including email, SMS, and so much more. In fact, take a look at this list of all the various things that you can do.
like adding or removing tags, if then branches, creating deals, tasks, adding delays, sending internal notifications, and of course campaigns, email and SMS.
Now that you have your drip sequence that's ready with the email copy and the videos, you are ready to publish. The important part here is to figure out which tags to use to associate with which contacts. Those tags can be dynamically added to contacts based on certain activities. It can be engagement, video watches, form fills, time-based things, or even something that you manually add. The key here is to make sure that your tags are clean, because those tags will trigger your entire campaign. It is possible to do this all in one day. We know that because we've done it, but that's not always the best path. Sometimes you want to work through things, be intentional, go through cycles, get team feedback. It is completely up to you. And don't forget, perfection is the enemy of progress. So get something out there. The video and the email drip sequence that you created is better than the perfect one that your competitor never created.
I wish you the best of luck on your journey in creating automated workflows. You want to start small with these and iterate slowly with time. And of course, if you need support, visit support.dubb.com, attend one of our live trainings, or send us an email at support@dubb.com.